It's morning time. We are ready to start the surgery. We are ready and prepared.
Just ready to get started here. What I'm doing is injecting the facelift. So we'll do a nice full infiltration so that we don't get bleeding. And what we're gonna do with the face, this is a young patient, she's 39. She's pretty young for a facelift, but she's starting to see the early descent of her mid-face, jowling, and some waxing in the neck. So she wants to be relatively aggressive about keeping her youthful looks and looking tight, so we're gonna do a facelift. Nice thing is we don't have to do a huge dissection because she doesn't need as much lift as if I was doing this in 20 years or so. We're also gonna do a buccal fat pad resection, so reduce some volume in her cheeks to try to bring out some thinness in her lower face. And then we're gonna do some facial fat grafting to soften some of the folds and wrinkles that she's got, and also to give her fuller lips. And then Dr. Restrepo is gonna work on the same time on the breasts.
So basically here we're going to take the fat that Dr. Campbell is going to use for the fat injection. We're going to take it from the lower abdomen. And regarding the breast, we are going to do a periareolar lift. With augmentation, we are going to do a dual plane augmentation to increase the volume and give a natural and perky look to the breast. What we have done here is start the dissection in the right breast. Here we have identified the pectoralis muscle that we are going to dissect a pocket under this muscle to create extra coverage for the breast in the upper pole, and in the lower pole will be covered by the normal breast tissue.
And up here, I've just gotten started on the facelift. You can see facelift is performed through an incision that's really pretty well hidden. I mean, I've got the incision open and you can really barely see it. So, and we use that to lift up the skin here. And I'm just dissecting slowly this area so I can get access to the underlying muscle under here. And eventually we'll be lifting that to pull the face. You can see even this early in the dissection, as I lift this muscle, the whole face comes back and up, which is the effect that we want. Okay, so what we've done is elevated the skin flap, and then we've got the underlying muscle. This is called the SMAS muscle. So it's really important to address that and lift that, because that's the underlying architecture of the face. And I've just got the first suture there, but you can see as I'm gonna pull that suture, it pulls the entire face tighter. So I'm gonna do a line of those from just above the mid-face all the way down into the upper part of the neck, and that'll give us our mid-face lift, our jawline tightening, and our neck lift.
So what we have done here is the dissection of the pocket, and we place a sizer that allows us to choose with the information that we got from the physical examination, the discussion with the patient, and the sizer here in the operating room. We can decide for the perfect implant according with what we have discussed and the best shape that we can get for the patient. So now we are going to move to the next, to the other side, and we will do the same thing. Okay, so what we have done is in this side we have the sizer and in this side we have the final implant. Now we are double checking that the pockets are dissected and the implants will look the same. And after that we can start the closure so we can get done with the breast.
What I'm doing up here is I'm doing the skin resection part of the facelift. So we've lifted the muscle internally, we pulled the skin back, and now I'm taking off excess skin that we very precisely marked so that that'll tighten everything up. Okay, really great case. We did everything we planned, full facelift neck lift, facial fat grafting, lip augmentation with fat, and buccal fat pad resection. That should all add up together to give her really a softer, younger look in the face. Then Dr. Restrepo did a beautiful breast augmentation with a lift, so she's got a nice full chest, which will really add to her figure. That took us a grand total of 3 hours and 15 minutes. So that's a real key in the way we do things, is using two plastic surgeons and two teams. By myself, I don't know, 7 hours, something, it'd be too much. But we were able to affect a big change in a very small amount of time. And I think for her, she's gonna love it. So really great case.